Friends, welcome to my next video on invoice verification. In my previous video, we had learnt about the part 3 of subsequent debits, credits, delivery cards and credit memos, which was on invoices without reference to purchase orders. Now we will go to the part 4, which is on credit memos and reversals. I have divided this into 3 sections. In the first section, we will learn about the overview of credit memos and reversals. In the section B, we will learn how to post credit memo for an invoice. And in section C, we will learn how to post subsequent credit for an invoice. So now we will take up the section A and learn about the overview of credit memos and reversals. So first we will know what are the credit memos and subsequent credits. If you see this figure here, there is a PO for 100 pieces of a certain material at 10 euro per piece. GR is done for 50 pieces. Then vendor sends invoice for 80 pieces, which is 30 pieces higher than the GR quantity. Next, the vendor says that he is not able to deliver the 30 pieces, which is already invoiced. So then he will send a credit memo for the 30 pieces, which is not received. And we will enter a credit memo in our system. Another example, GR is done for 50 pieces, but vendor has sent a invoice for 50 pieces only, but at a higher amount. But invoice amount is for 80 pieces, but the quantity in invoice is only 50 pieces only, but the amount is 800 euro. So here, for 50 pieces, the amount should have been 500 euro. Instead of 500 euro, he has put a amount of 800 euro. So what is going to happen? We will post invoice for 50 pieces at 800 euro only. Then the vendor will accept his error and then he will send a subsequent credit for 50 pieces and amount 300 euro. Then what we will do? We will enter a subsequent credit for this PO for 300 euro. Okay. So the quantity remains the same. So now, the main difference between credit memo and subsequent credit is that credit memo is used to adjust the quantity invoiced, but subsequent credit is used to adjust the value invoiced. That is the main difference between a credit memo and a subsequent credit. We will know some more points about credit memo and subsequent credit. We usually receive a credit memo from a vendor if the vendor invoices quantity was more than GR quantity. Credit memo is used to adjust the quantity invoiced. When we post the credit memo, the total invoiced quantity in the PO history is reduced by the credit memo quantity. The maximum quantity we can post a credit memo is the quantity that has already been invoiced. In the case of a credit memo, the system assumes that the credit memo belongs to a return delivery or reversal of the goods received. This means we have to reverse the GR for the quantity not received and then we can post the credit memo. For example, if we have posted GR for higher quantity and then we have to post a credit memo for the quantity not received, then what we need to do? We have to reverse the GR for the quantity not received and then we can post the credit memo. And one more point is, in credit memo, the system will post account postings to GRIR clearing account. We can see after posting a credit memo. Example of a credit memo is PO number 45000180027. I will show this PO here. This is an example of a credit memo here. 45000180027. If we see the PO here for the line item 10, here, it is for 20 pieces at 100 rupees per piece. Now, GR is done for 15 pieces only. See, we see the GR only 15 pieces. Then, if you see the invoice, vendor has sent invoice for full PO quantity of 20 pieces. Then, vendor what the vendor will do? He will say that he is not able to deliver the 5 quantity which is not yet delivered, and he will send a credit memo for the 5 pieces which is not received. So this is a credit memo here. I will show you. This is a credit memo for the 5 pieces which is not yet received. and the amount is 500 rupees. Next, I have shown an example of a credit memo also. Now we will move to subsequent credit. If the PO value is 1000 rupees, but vendor has invoice for 1050 rupees, now vendor sends subsequent credit of rupees 50 to us. Subsequent credit is used to adjust the value invoiced. So it is used to reduce the value of the invoice by the amount which is invoiced excessively by the vendor. Here in this example, the vendor has invoice for 50 rupees higher than the PO price of 1000 rupees. So he will send a subsequent credit of 50 rupees to us. We post a subsequent credit if the price in the invoice is too high. Here the total quantity invoiced for the purchase order item remains the same, but the total value of invoice is reduced. Example of a subsequent credit is PO number 45000180028. I will show this one. This is the example of a subsequent credit here. So here, if we see the PO here, if you see the PO for the line item 20, it is for 10 pieces. Okay, each is 200 rupees per piece. So GR is done for 10 pieces. We can see the GR is done for 10 pieces. Then invoice. He sends invoice for 10 pieces only, but at a higher amount of 2050 rupees. But the actual PO amount is 2000 only. So he has invoice at a higher price of 50 rupees more than the actual PO price. Next, what he will do? He will accept this error and then he will send a subsequent credit of 50 rupees to us. Okay, this is an example of a subsequent credit. Next, the account movements made when we post a credit memo or subsequent credit are made according to the same rules as when we post an invoice. The system posts to the same accounts but with the opposite sign next to the entry. For example, here, I have shown you here. This is an example of a credit memo. Credit memo, right? So here, I will show that one. It is a credit memo here. We can see here. So here, the account movement in the credit memo is opposite to that in the invoice. For example, when I had posted invoice for this 2000 rupees, the sign was plus. Now, when I post a credit memo, the sign will be minus here. We can see the minus sign here. And here, in the example of subsequent credit also, we can see this one. When I had posted the invoice, this is the invoice, right? When I had posted the invoice, the sign was plus. And when I had posted the subsequent credit, the sign is minus here. I can see here minus. Okay, that is about the subsequent credit and credit memo. Next, cancelling invoices. So here, if you see the figure here, there is a PO for a certain material for 100 pieces at 10 euro per piece. Invoice, before invoice, that is GR is done for 50 pieces, and then he sends an invoice for 50 pieces, same quantity as received. Next, we post some invoice document. Invoice document is generated. Next, we come to know that there is some error in the invoice, some data error. Then what we will do, we will cancel the invoice. And then when we cancel the invoice, system will generate a credit memo. Credit memo. Next, invoice documents, either invoices or credit memos, can be subsequently cancelled if they were posted incorrectly with some data error. There are two separate cases. If we cancel an invoice, the system automatically generates a credit memo. If we cancel a credit memo, the system automatically generates an invoice. For example, I will show some example here. In one PO, 18045001802024. Here, if we go to the item detail here in this PO, here I had posted an invoice. Okay, so I had cancelled this invoice. When he cancelled the invoice, system has generated a credit memo. You can see it is a credit memo here. You can see it is a credit memo. So, example here. So, one more. This is the example. And I will show one more example here. Here, this is an example of a cancellation of a credit memo here. See, first I had posted an invoice. then I had posted a credit memo. Credit memo for 500 rupees for five pieces. So what I have done? I have cancelled this credit memo. When you cancel this credit memo, system will generate an invoice. See here, invoice like this. So if we cancel a invoice, system will generate a credit memo. And if we cancel a credit memo, system will generate an invoice. Okay, that I have already shown practically in the system. When we cancel or reverse an invoice, the system automatically creates a credit memo based on the data in the invoice document. The system automatically determines the credit memo amount and quantity from the invoice. This avoids any variances between the invoice and the credit memo. When we reverse an invoice, the account movements made when the invoice was posted cannot always simply be reversed. They are reversed only if there is sufficient stock coverage. For example, when I had posted an invoice, okay, that time the system has done the account movements as per the invoice. Now, when I cancel the invoice, at that time, if there is sufficient stock, then only the account movements are reversed. Otherwise, they are not. So, when we post an invoice with a price variance for a material with moving average price, postings are made to the stock account if there is sufficient stock coverage only. But when we reverse the invoice and there is insufficient stock coverage, the system posts the price difference in the credit memo to a price difference account. Although the price variance was debited to the stock account when we posted the invoice. So, what the system will do? If there is sufficient stock coverage, then only the account movements are reversed. Otherwise, when we cancel or reverse the invoice, and at the time of cancellation or reversal of the invoice, and there is no sufficient stock or there is insufficient stock, then the system will post the price difference in the credit memo to the price difference account. Next, when we reverse an invoice, all items in the invoice document are reversed. We can also reverse part of an invoice only by manually entering a credit memo. We can only reverse only part of an invoice by manually entering a credit memo. So, we cannot reverse a reversal document, which means once invoice document is reversed, it cannot be reversed again. For example, if I had reversed an invoice, system had generated a credit memo, that I cannot reverse. And if I had reversed a credit memo, system had generated an invoice, that also I cannot reverse. So, this is about the overview of credit memos and reversals. So, in my next video, we will take up section B, where we will learn how to post credit memos for the invoice. And then we will take up the how to post subsequent credit for an invoice in section C. Thank you for watching my video. Please give me your valuable comments, likes, and please subscribe to my channel so that you will not miss any notification of my upcoming videos and several scenarios on MM. Thank you for your time and see you in my next video.